Tesla FSD Beta 10.4. Some are saying it's a huge improvement, while others are saying the exact opposite. I'm Frugal Tesla Guy, and I'm going to give you my thoughts after 1 week of using it. Once I got FSD Beta version 10.4, my first reaction as a YouTube content provider was to share my first driving experience. But once I went on that drive, I realized I didn't want to waste anyone's time with what turned out to be a pretty uneventful drive. Unless there are major changes in the overall behavior of the car, it's not worth my time or, more importantly, yours to watch a video that doesn't give you much in the way of new information. So what I wanted to do was take it through the paces with some of the more challenging spots in town to see if there are any improvements. Then wrap it up with my overall impressions. So let's get started. Now this is the first morning that I got FSD Beta 10.4. So if you can see, it's at night. It's when I'm driving to work at about 3:30 to 4 o'clock in the morning. Now, if you recall from my first video that I've ever done, this is the intersection that I let the car go through the red light. Now, I haven't done that since then, but you can see here the stop sign, so it's stopping there. And it's going to make a right turn. There's only room for one car, by the way, to wait here at the red light to turn left. It wanted to go through once again. I had to stop. I had to intervene here and put my foot on the brake. Now, it turned green immediately after that, and it probably would have been safe to let it go through. But that being said, it was going through the red light. So I did send that on over to Tesla. So, you know, to make it fair, because, you know, there have been arguments that it has a more difficult time at night. And that certainly is the case here. So I decided to try this intersection one more time during the day when there, of course, is more traffic as well. Now, as you can see here at the stop sign, there is a truck there waiting. Now, the proper thing to do here is to just wait until that light turns green and the truck goes, and then you can go. Now, it continued to creep forward, and I didn't want to do that. As you can see, there's another car to my left. So I wasn't quite sure what FSD Beta was going to do. So I had to disengage because I didn't want to create any problems with that car to my left. So as you can see, that projection line is having some difficulties. It wanted to go straight, then it wants to go right. But it does seem as though at this point it is waiting. So it is, in a sense, doing the proper thing, but it's also kind of just slowly nudging. But in the end, even though it's supposed to make a right turn here, it actually ends up going straight. So I did have to take over the wheel and then take to the right and then turn to the left. So I had to go through the intersection on my own. But once again, it just seemed to fail that test once again. But a very difficult intersection. All right, so here I am, first day again on my way to work. This is the right turn that it typically has had a lot of problems in the previous versions. So as we can see here, it's slowing down properly. It actually is making the right turn without any problems, but it ended up going to the right of the bike lane there, and then eventually corrected itself and got back into the center of the lane, the proper part of the lane. So I sent that over to Tesla. But once again, I wanted to be fair and try this again at night, during the day, that is. So again, in the past too, I've had problems with it getting into that right lane there where that car just went to the right, but it didn't do that this time. It's going straight, beautiful, good pace here. And it's slowing down to make this right turn. As you can see, there's a truck there too. That's a little bit in the way, but you know, that's not gonna create any problems. It's turning right here without any issues at all and getting into the proper part of the lane. So a success there, and probably one of the best turns in FSD Beta 10.4. Now in previous versions, as it's turning left here, it gets way too close to the curb. It looks like it is close here, but not nearly as close as it was last time. And last time it stayed very close to the curb, where this time it corrected itself and got in the center of the lane here. You can see it's stopping short of the red light. You know, that doesn't make me too comfortable, especially if there are cars coming behind me. But once the light does turn green, it goes through. Now again, keep in mind, the light is always going to be red directly after this. Now there was a pedestrian there, so it did stop short. And then once the pedestrian got out of the way, it did move forward. Now one of the things is this, is it kept creeping forward at the red light, and it did eventually stop on its own, but now it's on the crosswalk, which obviously is not a good thing. Now there were cars coming into the intersection, as you can see here. That may have been another reason why it stopped, but as it turned green, you'll notice that car turning in there, it slowed down for that car. Not sure why, because it wasn't in the way, but it did anyway. And of course, now we got through the green light there. So I thought I'd give it another shot. And as you can see, once again, there actually is a car in front of us. And it's kind of creeping a little bit more to the left here. And what I find interesting is this time, once it got to the left side here, it slowly made its way to the line. As you can see right here, no cars behind me. But actually this time, it stopped right there at the line. So it did that properly. But again, what you'll see here is once the light in front of us turns green, we're gonna have to watch the other one that's red. It's moving through forward there and moving fast. So I did have to put my foot on the brake and disengage FSD beta. Now I re-engaged it and it did recognize it this time once I re-engaged it as a red light. So that being said, it was successful there. And then of course, once this light does turn green, it's going to end up going through without any problems. So I thought I'd give it one more shot to see if this would work. And you can see, again, it's coming kind of the left side or the center of that yellow line. It does stop short of the line there for the traffic light, but it did stop. So that obviously, again, is kind of one of those things where it'd be nice if it stopped at the line, but at least it's stopping at the red light properly and getting us safely. Now it's going through this green light, and as you can see right here, it actually does stop this time right at the line at the red light, partially maybe because those cars were there, but it did not continue to progress forward until the light turned green. All right, this is another intersection. Now, this left turn is actually, I've had problems with this before, where it kind of wanted to turn left and then go straight, and it was an issue, but now no problems here. Now, what's interesting about this time is you'll see that it gets into the right lane here. Now, the reason I say this is interesting is because in the past, it would stay in the left lane, and then once the light would turn green, it would actually turn left, which is actually a one-way street. One of the reasons I zoomed in on this is I want you to see where those cars and that truck is going. Look at that line, that center line. It's showing it kind of going back and forth as a double yellow line when it's not a double yellow line. Where we are progressing forward here, it is all one way. It is all one way traffic, but it is beginning to recognize it as a yellow line. Now this is something to take note because I think that's one of the reasons why it wanted to turn left when it was in the left side here. All right, so it went through the green light, no problems. Didn't want to turn left, it was great. So we are now approaching another intersection that I wanted to kind of highlight here because I've actually never really had any problems with it in the past, but coming up here, you have three lanes in which you can turn left from. You're going into a one-way lane here, or one-way street, that is. So as it approaches this left turn, it wants to get as far left as it can. You can see that blue car to the left there. It's in the way, so it can't get into the left lane. So unfortunately, at least for the car, it had to turn left in the center lane. Not a problem for most people. But it was a little uncomfortable, too uncomfortable for me to not disengage with that truck that was on my right side. I sent that over to Tesla. It probably wouldn't have hit the car, but it was just way too close for comfort, so I had to disengage. All right, so last time it went through this intersection just fine, but I've had problems with the car wanting to turn left right here when that's a one-way street on the left side there. So I forced it to stay in the left lane. Now as the light turns green, it's not moving forward, and the reason being, it wants to be on the right lane there to go straight. So it was waiting for traffic to clear on the right side. I did have to disengage because I didn't want to hold up traffic, but a slight improvement here because at least it didn't attempt to turn left. All right, so now we're going to take it to that intersection again. We actually are making it to the middle lane, and this time it turned left successfully. Now, part of the reason it may have been successful is because there were no cars to the right, so I didn't have to feel feel uncomfortable, but it made it through without any problems there. All right, let's go ahead and take you now to roundabouts, and this one it's never really succeeded in it, but it's at least shown signs of attempting to go a little bit more to the left, but this time just went straight through. Now, I'm not gonna waste your time and show you the other times because it does the exact same thing and never really successfully made it to that roundabout. All right, so this series of roundabouts, there's a couple in here that I wanted to highlight, because what was interesting about this first roundabout is the fact that once we got to it, number one, I wanted to mention that FSD Beta 10.4 is doing a great job in slowing down at these roundabouts instead of just going straight through pretty quickly. It felt pretty dangerous. Now, we had the right of way here and could have gone first, but it actually waited for this truck, which I thought was the right decision because sometimes you don't know what the other cars are going to do. So we made it safely through this first roundabout. And this next is actually not a roundabout, but it's a stop sign. But here's a nice illustration of a typical California stop, right, where it doesn't really stop completely. So a nice little roll through here. I was pretty pleased with it. It was safe. There were no other cars coming. So here we have another roundabout coming up. And once again, just illustrating how it is slowing down. Like as I mentioned, in the past, it's been going through these roundabouts very quickly, and that has been creating some concern with the overall safety. Now, it did come to a complete stop here. It may have done that because of the pedestrian, as you can see walking there, but overall, it made it through this roundabout safely, and I really didn't have too many concerns about safety coming through this one as well. So I think we are doing better, at least with these roundabouts, with FSD Beta 10.4. This one I wanted to highlight because it was an attempt to make a right turn at a red light. So as you can see here, it actually stopped quite well. It stopped right there at the line. It's creeping forward, checking for visibility. Now this car goes by and then it wanted to go, but I had to disengage here. See that car that just passed by? It wanted to go in front of that. There just wasn't enough room between those two cars and I had to stop. So as you can see here, I'm fully disengaged. Then I waited until it was safe and I went through this and made the right turn on my own and then re-engaged FSD Beta. But I just really wasn't too happy with that right turn. Now I noticed some very subtle improvements in some of the more challenging spots in town, along with no improvements at all. Now unless I record every single drive, I can't document everything that happens on my daily drives. However, I do use FSD Beta almost 100% of the time, allowing me to observe how the car performs in certain situations and then compare that to previous versions. So let's start with some of the more known and common issues that at least I've been dealing with since day one. Phantom braking. Some people noticed a major improvement in 10.4, but for me, it's just as bad as the previous versions I've had. Stop signs. A majority of the time, it continues to stop short of the line and still takes way too long to make a left turn or a right turn or even go straight, many times missing out on opportunities and waiting for the next. What I end up doing a majority of the time is I give the accelerator a nudge to help move things along. Now, this also happens regularly at stoplights, especially for right turns. No center line. My neighborhood road does not have a center line, and as a result, it drives very close to the center of the road and really doesn't move over enough when a car approaches from the other side. I typically disengage FSD Beta to give them some room. Which lane? It's frequently in the wrong lane for future turns and wants to wait way too long to change to the proper lane. And when the turn is coming up, it may not have an opportunity to turn into the correct lane because of traffic, and as a result, may miss the turn. Now, this can typically be avoided if it turned into the proper lane earlier when all was clear. Also, when it turns left and there is a left turn lane immediately on the road it's turning onto, it will go into that lane. If you need to go straight, it will go into the lane to the right and continue forward. However, if there's traffic in the way, it will be forced to either make the left turn or stop and wait while holding up other cars behind you in the process. Now, the same thing can happen on right turns as well. Now, there may be other issues you may be experiencing, but these are some of the most common issues I've noticed since day one. Now, as mentioned earlier, there have been some minor improvements. I've noticed some left and right turns are very smooth and confident, better than what I've experienced so far. Some of my trouble spots are no longer trouble spots anymore, and it seems 10.4 has been able to fix the problem. But one last thing I would like to mention about FSD Beta 10.4. I've had to disengage FSD beta far more frequently on this version than the two previous versions. Some drives are almost flawless, while others are a complete mess. So much so that if my wife is in the car, I can hear a lot of gasps and deep breaths. Quite honestly, she's really not all that impressed with FSD beta. Now, with all that said, and I say this in almost all of my FSD beta videos, this is not FSD, but rather FSD beta. And some people might even argue it's in alpha form. But any way you look at it, it's still a work in progress. Also, I, like many others, are coming into the FSD beta game a lot later than the original testers. They have been there since day one and have seen some major improvements in the last year. I only have a month under my belt, so my experience is very limited at this point. But despite the number of hits I'm throwing at FSD beta, I still have faith in the hardworking team at Tesla. We can't forget what the FSD beta team is doing behind the scenes, working hard each day, and with every software update, they are bringing us one step closer to full self-driving. Well, thank you all so much for watching, and you know the drill. Like, subscribe, and stay positively charged.